resistance is futile.
Boldly going where no show has gone before. This is the Week in Geek with David D. Squared, your source for geek and pop culture news that's trending now. Broadcasting from the Gregory Ricks and Associates Wealth Management Studios, here's D. Squared.
Greetings, people of Earth! This is the Week in Geek, your source for geek and pop culture news that's trending now. I am your host, D. Squared. All right, let me lay out the show for you. It is our yearly Gifts for Geeks holiday extravaganza, and we are going to be bringing you all the gift ideas that you could possibly want for the nerd or geek in your life. So, to help me along with that is my boy, Scungy. Scungy, hey, what's shaking, bacon?
Not much, sir.
You don't sound festive. Come on, kick it up a notch, punk. It's freaking Christmas, man. Of course, it's December 5th.
It's Christmas, 5th. And I've been beaten down so far in the retail life. So, Christmas.
Oh, baby boy, I'm so sorry, bro. So, with that in mind, we're going to do our Gifts for Geeks. You've got a lot of game stuff we're going to be talking about. But we need to definitely start it all off with this. Your top nerd news stories from around the world, brought to you by the Viridian Tea Company. Find them on Etsy. And now, your top nerd news stories. All right, so to top us off with our top nerd news stories is this.
Wakey, wakey, bro.
Something better. No, bro. Come on, bro. But he's criticizing. Okay.
Look, guys.
Keep Bishop is guy, bro.
Bro, we are...
Bro,
founder.
Bro, the Hawkeye Disney Plus series, the Tracksuit Mafia. How many Tracksuit Mafia think we're going to see at a Fan Expo coming up in January, Scungy? How many?
I've got my money on the high 20s.
Yeah, I think that's low.
It's a tracksuit.
It is the best, easiest cosplay, and then all you got to do is just walk around saying bro all day, bro. And then, of course, you'll probably have, like, the Deadpool bro combos. It's just going to take on a strange life of its own. But talking about the Hawkeye Plus series, Hawkeye on Disney Plus, we're 3 episodes in. It drops on Wednesdays. So far, I really like it. I know a lot of people are like, well, what's going on with it? You know, we're not getting it. You know what? It's a show. It's funny. I like seeing Jeremy Renner as Hawkeye. Just kind of, he's just a dude. He's got a bow and arrow. What do you want from him? But in the last episode, the third one, when he starts pulling out the Hank Pym arrow, I lost it, dude. When she shoots that arrow up in the sky and he pings it with a Pym arrow and it just becomes a giant arrow, that was awesome, dude. I love that it's just an entertaining show. I don't know what story they're building on this. I really don't care. But so far, I'm enjoying the hell out of it, man.
You know what? It's one that I've yet to watch it yet. I'm
Shut
waiting.
Up, bro.
I've been a little apprehensive. I know, but look, there are 3 episodes, like you said. Now I'm going to start this week. That way I can kind of binge a couple of episodes. I mean, I've gotten spoiled with binging shows now. So it's hard to watch one a week.
Well, look, if you want to binge something, starting on, Friday, December 17th, The Witcher Season 2 premieres on Netflix. Now, they'll drop them all at the same time, so you won't have to, wait for them all to come out. Somebody will stay up all night and binge them and then try to spoil them on Twitter and Facebook and every other social media platform they have out there. But The Witcher, we've got old Geralt with his little grunting. Bro. Wow, there you go. Geralt Tracksuit Mafia. There we go. Somebody make that happen. Somebody make that happen for Fan Expo. Just go around, bro. So, The Witcher Season 2, actually, that was a surprise hit. Maybe not a surprise hit, but I was surprised that I liked it as much because, honestly, I don't think your boy can act his way out of a paper bag. But, people say he's nice to look at, so whatever. Y'all have fun with that. But I did like the series, and, toss a coin to your Witcher. That's just a phenomenal song. So, There's that.
Oh, yeah.
Now, moving on, we go back to the big screen. You know, last Monday was Spider Monday. I don't know when anybody did anything, if somebody, like, saved a spider, you know, like, oh, there's a spider in my house. I'll put it on a piece of toilet paper and put it outside. Yay. But Friday, December 17th, did you get your tickets yet, Scungy? Because actually...
No, I need to.
No, you don't. Don't sweat it. All right, this is what just kind of boggles my brain. My son was telling me they got tickets going for $1,000 in Los Angeles and New York. Well, meanwhile, here in New Orleans, if you want to go on the freaking 17th, you know, they've got like 30 different screens showing it all. And they start at like 4 p.m. on that Thursday. It used to be like midnight only. It's like Black Friday. It's just sort of oozed into Thursday and occasionally onto a Wednesday. So it's out there. I was literally looking at it about an hour or two ago. You can still get front and center seats. They got entire screens that have, you know, complete and total vacancy. So I don't sweat it, man. Get your tickets whenever the hell you feel like it, because this is something where you know you don't want to watch social media until you've seen the movie. Weird side note, though, it apparently airs in Europe 12 hours before it hits America. So if you have any friends across the pond, don't talk to them. Don't check their social media feeds, because then, you know, it's going to get spoiled for you. So I don't know what the over-under is on Tobey Maguire and Andrew Garfield showing up, but I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen to this movie. And then, you know what? I really just don't want to know. I want to go in there and enjoy the heck out of it and not, you know, why do people overthink this stuff? Just go in and enjoy the damn movie, man. I don't get it.
Because they've been built up. So this series has been built up so much, and we're basically, it's phase four. So this is like the first real theatrical release that's really phase four. So people are so excited about it. But I mean, regardless, it's going to be a fun movie. That's the thing. It's going to be fun, but it's not going to, since it's so anticipated, people aren't going to, they're going to bitch about it.
Well, yeah, there you go. All right, Matrix Resurrection comes out December 22nd on HBO Max and in theaters. You know, Keanu Reeves makes his triumphant return back to the Matrix. This looks like it's going to be a great, fun little movie. I'm not sure what's going to be going on with this, but yet again, I don't care. I just want to go see the movie and enjoy it. And I guess, you know, you can't have enough... too much Keanu Reeves, honestly. They're just can't have enough.
Absolutely not.
So that's coming out December 22nd. Now, also on the same day, Sing 2 comes out, which is a guilty pleasure of mine. Sing, that first
one.
I
love Sing.
I swear.
It's such a great film.
It really is, man. It was just so much fun, man. And now, even though, you know, I could care less what Bono does, it does, I don't know, like when they are building up to it, just the little trailers get me all like, oh, this is going to be so great. I'm a dork when it comes to these things. So Sing 2, December 22nd. Finally, The King's Man from the Kingsman movies is coming out Wednesday, December 22nd as well. We've been waiting on this one for like 2 years. I remember playing the trailer about 2 years ago, pre-COVID. So it's been sitting on a shelf gathering dust for a while. So The King's Man comes out. And then finally, on December 24th, we're going to get this new movie called Don't Look Up. It's got Jennifer Lawrence, Leonardo DiCaprio, and you told me you hadn't even heard about this movie. So here, take a listen to this.
This is not real. This is not real. This is not real. This isn't happening. Kate, tell me this isn't really happening.
I hear there's something you don't like the looks of.
We discovered a very large comet.
Oh, good for you.
It's headed directly towards Earth.
This comet is what we call a planet killer.
At this exact moment, I say we sit tight and assess.
Sit tight and assess?
Sit tight.
And then assess. The sit tight part comes first, then you gotta digest it. That's the assessment period.
That's Jonah Hill.
This is the worst news in the history of humanity. He just blew us off.
What are we gonna do? We have to release the information.
So we just leak it.
Our guests today have made a pretty big discovery in space.
How big is this thing going? I can't destroy my ex-wife's house. Is that possible?
There's a 100% chance that we're all going to die.
Hey.
Well, the handsome astronomer can come back anytime, but the yelling lady, not so much.
Not so much.
All right, so I'm going to just pausing it here for a second. So to give you an idea, the first person they were talking to was the president, and Jonah Hill is, I guess, the president's, I don't know, you know, aide-de-camp, whatever the hell you call it. They're stoolie. And it's just like, yeah, we sit tight and assess. So they're trying to go and tell people, and this just so smacks of reality in the world that we are in right now, where they go on a morning talk show, and it's just like, oh, you wacky pranksters. Oh, we're all going to die. Oh, yeah. Yeah, whatever. And it just goes from there, because then they start showing snippets of him like on Sesame Street trying to get people's attention, but he keeps going. Hold on.
We're gonna get the news out there one way or another.
It's real and it's coming.
FBI!
Jesus Christ, you could have just called me.
This comet contains $30 trillion worth of material.
What do trillions of dollars matter if we're all gonna die?
Oh, no, what if we're rich? Dangerous. That would be terrible.
You guys discovered a comet? I have a tattoo of a shooting star on my back.
Oh, that's terrific.
That's Ariana Grande.
Taco Bell Grande?
Yes.
This is already a disaster.
You know that girl from Live TV said we're all gonna die?
No.
Yo, bro!
You'll never take me alive! There it is!
Giant comet hurtling its way towards Earth!
Can you see it?
I can't! My head is in a bag!
I did have the FBI put that bag over your head. They don't do that. The CIA does, but I made them do it.
You know, I had a feeling.
It's a good feeling, because that is what I did, and it was very funny and cool.
Don't Look Up, coming out on Netflix Friday, December 24th. Dude, Meryl Streep, Jonah Hill, you got Ariana Grande, Leonardo DiCaprio, J-Law, Timothy Chalamet. I mean, the list goes on. And this is like quite literally what would probably happen if real scientists found out that we were all going to die in a month. Everybody'd be like, yo, TikTok, we're all going to die. What up, deuces, baby? We're all going to die. And it's just probably, it would probably be better for all of us if that really were the case, because, oh my God, this is exactly what would happen, Scotchy.
Oh my God. You know what? After you had told me, I actually went really quick and watched that trailer.
Oh, you cheated, and, huh?
Oh my God.
Dude, my head is in a bag. You know, the CIA does that. I did that. That's pretty funny, right? I mean, like, it is so petty and salty. I just love every second of it, but this is what would happen. Oh no, what if we were rich? It is so great. All right, look, we need to go to break, and when we come back, we'll kick off the Gifts for Geeks extravaganza, the holiday special. But first, Scungy, you believe in miracles, right? Miracles do happen. Christmas miracles, right?
Sometimes.
Sure. Well, here, listen to this miracle.
First victory of the year on the line. Goff's got it. Back, looks, throws, and
yes!
Caught! Touchdown, Detroit Lions! They did it! Amon-Ra St. Brown in the receiving end! Oh, they're rushing the field! They've done it! 3-0 on the clock! This game is over! It's over!
It's a Christmas miracle
to Amon-Ra St. Brown.
The Lions have won their first game. Way to go, Lions.
They are now 1 win, 10 losses, and a tie. Go ahead. It's a Christmas miracle. This is the Week in Geek on News Talk 99.5 WRNO. Box tea again? Why don't you try the tea blends from the Viridian Tea Company? They sell blends that are guaranteed to make you think outside the box, with blends like Quantum Mechanics, Caligula's Herbal Nerve Tonic, and Manta Ray Dreaming. Your tea experience will be out of this world. Look for the blends at Tubby and Coo's Mid-City Bookshop at 432 North Anthony Street, or online at Etsy at the Viridian Tea Company. So put down the box and order some tea from the Viridian Tea Company today. Sincerely, your taste buds.
And from the Storm fanzine highlights black female characters in comics and sci-fi. The fanzine is for and by black women, featuring original artwork, interviews, and cultural criticism. As black women fans, we have unique perspectives that are often silenced and discouraged in mainstream outlets. And from the Storm is a shelter from the storm, a place for black women to gather, learn, and discuss our black female nerddom. Find them at infromthestormzine.com or at infromthestorm on Facebook.
My name is Optimus Prime, and you are listening to The Week in Geek. Autobots, transform and roll out.
Welcome back in to The Week in Geek, your source for geek and pop culture news that's trending now. I am your host, D-Squared. Along for the ride is my boy, Scungy, with his, not pick of the week, but it is the gifts of the holiday season for the nerds in your life. But first, I want to strongly urge you to check out our Facebook page, facebook.com/TheWeekInGeek. Check out our website, or maybe not, at twigradio.com. But definitely, definitely follow us on Twitter at twigradio, the Instagram's The Week in Geek. And Scungy, how can people listen to this show?
Well, if you missed any part of tonight's show, or you want to hear, you know, Dave go off about, like, you know, the government again.
Christmas miracles, always, the Lions won!
Christmas miracle! Sorry. Okay. You can always find us on Spreaker.com or download Spreaker for your smartphone or tablet. We're also on iTunes, YouTube, Google Play, Stitcher, Spotify, and that beautiful iHeartRadio app.
There you go. All right, so let's get into the video game portion. So for the gamers in your life, you can ask them, hey, you know, do you like video games? And if you do, you can find some way to sneak into the conversation and find out if they have a game or don't. And Scungy, let's get into it. You've got a whole page full of games, so let's just start at the top and work our way down.
So, yeah, there was a lot of cool releases this year, so there's a really good variety out there. The first one, and it's basically I'm going by, like, release. This stuff going from earlier in the year to, like, more recently.
All right.
Scott Pilgrim versus the World game. It's a downloadable game, but it's on all platforms. It's an old-school beat-em-up. Lots of fun.
All right. Speaking of that, wasn't there a Cobra Kai one, too? Didn't they have a Cobra Kai game?
There was a Cobra Kai one.
Yes! Okay, sorry.
It was like a fighter, like a one on, like kind of like a beat 'em up, like those old school beat 'em ups as well.
Yes, sorry.
You got Super Mario 3D World came out this year. It's lots of a remake of the one on the Wii U. I also put on here, there's a game called Balan Wonderworld. Now, this is, if somebody buys this for you, punch them in the throat. That's the worst game made this year.
Wait, what is it called?
Balan Wonderworld. All right. Legitimately, this is one of the worst games made ever.
So
it's terrible. So
why?
If somebody buys it for you, throw punch them.
So this is just a warning to not buy this game? Is that what you're doing here?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So buyer beware.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
I gotcha. Okay.
There's also a game called It Takes Two came out, which is a co-op only game where you play as these dolls that come to life, and you have to work together to go through the levels, and you can only play a co-op.
Wow. You have to play with a friend?
Yeah, it's like a Pixar movie come to life.
Oh, my God, that sounds awful. Man.
Yeah, it's actually really fun. One of my favorite games of the year, Disco Elysium, actually got a physical release recently, so you can actually buy a disc for it on the PlayStation and Xbox. It is a... It's really, I can't even explain it. It's a detective game, but it is so, so good.
Oh, yeah, that's the one where everybody's, like, on drugs or whatever, but it's like a noir. No, that's something else. But, no, I get it. It's like the game creators were on drugs when they made it. I got it.
Basically, they had to be.
Yep. All right.
You've got Baldur's Gate Dark Alliance was remade and came out digitally.
Yeah, and it's actually, it's on Game Pass, too. It's on Game Pass.
No. That one's not on. The new Dark Alliance is. Brand new game. This is the original one that came out around 2000.
Oh, okay.
So they remade that one.
Sorry. I'm just touching buttons here. Sorry. Okay.
Good. That's all right, Squirrel.
Dungeons and Dragons ride. Oh, I mean, the Dark Alliance, so it's the remake. Okay, not the new one.
Yeah, it's so then a Resident Evil Village, Resident Evil 8 came out this year to literally make me wet my pants.
Oh, man, that movie's out right now, too. Crap-a-doodles. I wanted to go see that. But I went and saw Ghostbusters first. Oh man, I gotta write this down. Go see.
I don't know if it could be scarier than this game. The segment of this game, it literally is the scariest.
No,
the
movie cannot be scary whatsoever. Maybe they just got jump scares. That'll be fun. The best part was with the Mila Jovovich ones, where those stupid evil dogs, because they were terrifying me in the game and they were terrifying in the movie. So good on them for that one. All right,
I highly suggest that one. There's a great value of Ghost of Tsushima Director's Cut. Ghost of Tsushima came out last year, but they re-released it this year with the Director's Cut with upgraded graphics. They added a couple other – there's a whole other island to go to. Mm. This game is fantastic. You cannot go wrong with that one.
So if you have somebody who is just, like samurais or ninjas, you're pretty much golden
on this
one. Akira
Kurosawa.
Yeah.
Akira Kurosawa, or if you like that Star Wars Visions first episode.
Oh, man. Look,
you're going to love this.
When we talk later and go through all the gifts, like there's a couple of books out there that I was going to urge people to go get for their loved ones. So, all right, continue. Sorry.
So, Psychonauts 2. I mean, anybody who's ever listened to me on the show knows that Psychonauts is in my top five of all times, and this game was just amazing. It was so much fun. Please give Tim Schafer all your money, because if you do, he makes more great games.
There you go. Dun, 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 dun.
Diablo 2 was re-released and updated this year.
Nice.
So, Diablo 2 was so much fun, and I loved it so much. So, I can't suggest that one enough. That one's so much fun. And they're cheap. That one's cheap, too. It's only $30.
Wow. Okay. That's a good deal.
Back for Blood. I know how much you love it.
So I do and I don't. All right. So look, actually, I was just playing it again last night, and here's why I hate it: because I hate people. I just do not enjoy playing video games with other people unless they're blood and they're sitting next to me. But no, man, I've just been playing the training things over again because it's just like, I don't want to get judged by some judgy McJudgerson out there about sucking at the game. So I guess I keep playing training, that maybe eventually I'll dip my toe out there and play with other people, because I don't need some jackass judging me on their headsets going, "Dude, you suck. Dude, you suck." I don't need that kind of stress in my life, man. I just want to kill some freaking zombies. But the speed at which it plays and the cards you get to add and the guns, it's really cool, because you go through the acts and you get stronger, better guns, yada, yada. It just sucks that you can't run them through all Act 1, 2, and 3, because I keep dying. I haven't finished the game yet because it's way too freaking hard. Maybe I do need friends, but who really needs friends? But yes, Back for Blood. If you like people, it's really great for you. If you don't like people, it's sort of great. So there you go. There's my shining. There you go. That's Back for Blood.
I'm 100% with you on that, because I don't like playing games online because I'm not good at them, and people yell at me, and I don't want to be stressed out when I play a video game. I want to enjoy myself.
Exactly. I don't need that kind of crap in my life, man. I don't need it. I go there to decompress, not be like, oh my God, I'm sorry, dude. I ain't playing a game and constantly going, sorry, sorry, sorry. No, I'm not doing that. But if you like that, Back for Blood. All right, what's next?
So, Guardians of the Galaxy also released this year. I just did a review a couple of weeks ago on this one. A lot of fun. If you don't like playing with people, this game's for you, because it's single player only.
That is so awesome.
And it is just so much fun. And if you like the movies, if you like the comics, if you like the movies, it's great. But if you like the comics, you're really going to like this one.
Yes. And it's got, cool dancing interludes, right? Yeah, pretty much.
Yes. Yes, you can just dance and go willy-nilly.
Yes.
You got that one. Another one that I'm going to review soon is called Evil Genius 2.
Ooh, what's that?
It's like those, think of like those world builders, like almost like a Sims, like a Sim City or a theme park or something like that, or theme hospital. This one, you're playing basically a Bond villain, and you're building up your evil lair and to do your schemes all around the world and try to take over the world in global domination.
What are we doing today, Brain? Same thing we do every day.
Hooked on a feeling.
Sorry. Okay. I couldn't fast forward it to the hook. So okay. All right. Planet take over the world. All right. So yes, evil genius. I think I saw that somewhere. It looked pretty cool. All right. What else we got?
It's on Game Pass. And then finally, we're going to end this with a game that's actually not out yet,
ooh,
but it comes out next week, and that's Halo Infinite.
Oh,
you can actually play it on Game Pass now, like some of the multiplayer on Game Pass. Like the campaign comes out next week, and it's Halo. It's basically Halo 6, and so it's the end of this trilogy. So it's Halo, man. I mean, it's the originator of online multiplayer, popularized online multiplayer with consoles.
Right.
So, yeah, I mean, it's going to be fun. And I've already played a little bit of the multiplayer, even though I normally don't. But so far, it's really fun.
Look, I play Fortnite because it's you against everybody. So I'm totally fine with that. Occasionally, I'll pair up with somebody I already know. And I know they're not going to get all, you know, like, dude, you suck. I'm shockingly good at Fortnite, surprisingly enough. So yeah, there you go. All right, so that's all we got. We're good. We're ready to do gifts next.
Yeah, sure. Why not? Let's talk about some nerdy gifts.
All right. Well, you know what? We'll end with the Fortnite stuff though, too, because The Rock, Dwayne The Rock Johnson, is in the new season of Fortnite, dude. Like it is so great. He's
everywhere.
He deserves to be. I love Dwayne Johnson. He's the best, man. I don't care what anybody says. I'll fight anybody. I love me Dwayne Johnson. So the new season of Fortnite is out now. So get your Fortnite friend or child or whatever. Get him some Fortnite coins and they'll be happy. So this is the week in Geek. And since Gremlins is a Christmas movie and this is a Christmas sort of special, this is the week in Geek on News Talk 99.5 WRNO.
There is nothing like quality when working with a business. That's why Banks Media Connections make sure that your work is done with class, professionalism, and style. Social media and marketing, IT work, videos, decals, documents, business cards, resumes, flyers, and presentations, Banks Media Connections has all of your media and clerical needs in mind. Contact me, Malcolm Banks, at 251-287-4854, or reach out to us on Facebook and Google. Banks Media Connections. If you have a need, we can help with speed.
D4 Tabletop Gaming Cafe at 8228 Oak Street wants to remind you that they are open for business. Tables are available for your next game night. Also, the Adventurers League is still running on Fridays at 7 p.m. and Magic the Gathering drafts are still on Saturdays at 1. So come over and check out their expanded inventory of miniatures and miniature paints, board games, RPGs, and TCGs. Find them on Facebook at D4 Tabletop Gaming Cafe or stop by the shop at 8228 Oak Street, just two blocks off of Carrollton. Or go to their website at d4cafe.biz.
Welcome back to The Week in Geek, your source for geek and pop culture news that's trending now. Don't forget, you can listen to previous episodes on the iHeartRadio app at The Week in Geek Radio Show. Here's D Squared.
Welcome back in to The Week in Geek, your source for geek and pop culture news that's trending now. Tonight, it is gifts for geeks that are trending now. What to get the gift for the geek or nerd in your life. We're doing a public service tonight, Scungy. That's what we're doing here for you. It's the 5th, and a lot of stuff that we're going to bring up, I made sure that you could actually get it delivered within before Christmas, or we'll send you to a brick and mortar place where you can find the stuff, or websites that actually can deliver it by Christmas, because it's December 5th right now, so you got roughly 20 days, I guess, you know, 19 days if we're really being honest here, or if you're one of those lucky people that does something, you know, with your friends post-Christmas, you know, then you got a little bit of cushion there, so you can kind of drag your feet on your presents there, right? That sounds fair, right?
Yeah.
All right, so
yeah,
let's all kick it all off with we did video games. I want to start this segment off with some board games, though. All right, the first two board games I got really are kind of throwbacks for older people. They're both by Ravensburger Games. They've made a ton of great fun little games. The first one is Gargoyles: The Awakening game. Now, Scungy, you told me you have that board game, right?
Yes, and it's a lot of fun, man.
It's the old school Gargoyles. The Gargoyles, the dark, sinister cartoon that was probably why we're so weird now, because it came out in the 90s. So we're warped because of that. So of course this game, it's got Goliath and the crew, and I forgot exactly what the theme of it was. I forgot. Are they protecting the castle? I think that's what it was, right?
Yeah, you're going around the city, going against Xanatos' men and whatnot, and it's actually like a story arc. There are different acts that you play.
Oh, I see. I didn't realize that from reading the back of the box. Okay. So
yeah,
there you go.
It's certain acts that you play and you go through, and it's an overarching story of five. I think it's five different acts.
Okay. So yeah, that's
so yeah.
$30 in a lot of places. You can try Go4 Games or D4 Games or Bad Wolf, etc. But I found them on Target for $30. So I mean, and they're pretty quick and reliable for delivering stuff. I don't want to tell anybody to go there first, because support our local people first. So
absolutely.
But now here's the other thing, the Princess Bride game. Now this one, Scungy, this one looks like it's just like it is inconceivably fun. And you have this one too. Is that a board game you don't have?
There are a lot I don't have, but yes, this one I own this one, and I've actually played it all the way through.
Shut up.
This one, the board is like a storybook. And there's a different chapter. Like, you start out in the farmhouse and you're playing as like Wesley trying to do chores to get Buttercup to love him. And then the next one, you're on the boat and you're trying to help Buttercup out of the eels. And then you're in the forest.
The Cliffs of Insanity.
Yes, because you actually climb the cliffs of Insanity. And it's so much fun. It's so charming, though, and it's easy, and it's great for the whole family.
There you go. $30 again. So, all right, those are the two first board games I got. What you got, man?
Well, man, you kind of take my thunder, because I had two board games for my first starting, too.
Okay. Well, see, we started right. Easy, though, because board games can pretty much, get for anybody. It doesn't have to be somebody who really is a board game junkie, It's just something, here's a board game. People like board games. At least I think. I don't know.
Yeah, I do. So the first one is with the hype of the brand new Dune movie out.
Oh.
There was a board game that came out earlier in the year, near the beginning of the year, called Dune Imperium.
Okay. I'm intrigued.
This is a board game that takes the worker placement idea, but adds deck building. So worker placement is where you put a worker down in a space and then you gain a resource or an ability for putting them in that space.
Okay.
Almost like an engine building. And then deck builders are where you constantly are putting new cards into your deck to make your and getting rid of old cards to make your decks better. This does a mix between the two using the theme of the movie. And it is, a lot of people think that it's on the top 10 of a lot of people's list for this year, and it rightly so is. It's a lot of fun. It's like only, I think it's only like $40 or $50, and they just came out with an expansion for it as well, so you're going to get fresh content with it. It's a fantastic game. You can find it, you could probably try Gopher Games, Bad Wolf there, but it's also at Barnes. They have one that's kind of exclusive to Barnes & Noble, so you might have to go there.
Ah, well, look, Barnes & Noble's got a whole bunch of stuff. I mean, look, it's a bookstore. I mean, I don't feel bad, even though it's a chain. I mean, They got a lot of cool stuff there. So going on the book note, I'll talk about Star Wars, you know, the Visions, the Disney Plus series Visions. They've got a couple of good books out, but one of the ones that I'm actually going to get for DJ, which I can comfortably say this because I know he sure as hell ain't listening to my show right now, Star Wars Ronin. So it is basically, it's kind of like that first episode with a Ronin samurai, but he's a Jedi. And so this is not a graphic novel. It's an actual book. So this is something for older readers, but also, you know, younger readers. And this is just something that it kind of straddles the line between like a book and anime, but also, you know, like if you've got somebody who likes the flavor of the Far East, but also loves Star Wars, it's kind of a nice little catch-all thing. So if you've got somebody who's hard to shop for, you know, maybe get them Ghost of Tsushima, or, you know, you get them this book, Star Wars Ronin, and you can get that wherever fine books are sold. There you go. What you got?
Nice.
Yeah.
My next pick, I'm gonna put the board game back for a little bit, and I'm gonna move on to, there's this Marvel Legends action figure series have been out for years.
Yeah,
all right,
they're really
nice action figures that they have made, that Hasbro's made for years, and they just released the What If action figure.
I know, from the
animated What If. Now, it comes with the Sorcerer Supreme, Doctor Strange, Captain Carter, Heist Nebula, T'Challa Star-Lord,
and
Zombie Captain America.
Yes! Oh my God.
And for some strange reason, Sylvie from Loki. But the reason why you need to buy them all is because Hasbro's Marvel Legends line has a thing called Build-A-Figure.
Right.
So if you buy all of them, you actually get an extra figure that you get to put together. And the extra figure for this is the Watcher.
No way. Seriously?
Yes.
Oh, all right. That's pretty dope, man. I dig that. Okay, we'll see. There you go.
So, yeah, you can find those. You can find those at GameStop, or you can find them online. It's like GameStop.com you can go to, or you can go anywhere basically that toys are sold and everything. I will tell you, they're about $20 a piece. So to buy them all, you're looking at about $120.
Yeah. So now
it's a good set.
Well, yeah, and look, shopping locally, so, you know, I went over and talked to our boy Mark over at D4 Cafe, but I stopped over at More Fun Comics, and this kind of rolls into my next pick, because they had the What If, and they had three of these zombie Captain America figures there at More Fun Comics, but also, I was looking at them on entertainmentearth.com. That's like kind of like, if you can imagine a action figure, they have it at entertainmentearth.com. And it's the Star Wars The Mandalorian Retro Series Collection, and it's Wave 1. It's got 8. It's got Cara Dune. It's got Greef Karga. It's got Moff Gideon. Then IG-11. Then Mando. Then Little Baby Yoda. And who is the I Have Spoken, the little guy, the little, you know,
Krill with a K.
Quirrell. That's it.
Quirrell.
So those, if you go to Entertainment Earth, they're $87.99, but they also have them at More Fun Comics, and I think you guys have them over at GameStop though too, huh? Because it's the retro reaction figure, so they're really awesome. And I'm going to keep on going with this one, because look, Hasbro Pulse. Go to HasbroPulse.com, because we talked about this a while ago, where they put out the gun for the Aliens game, and they've got three different they're not Kickstarters. It's called HasLab.
They're crowdfunding.
Yeah, it's HasLab is what it's called. They've got three different ones going on right now. The first one is they've got the Rancor, the Black Series, but there's a whole bunch of little add-ons and stuff. Now, some of this stuff, I got to warn you, this is expensive as snot. So this is like for a husband or wife, a spouse of something where, you know, you're getting it for them and you know they're going to appreciate it, because like the Rancor one starts at like $400. But there's also a Proton Pack that they're making, a legitimate straight up Proton Pack at $400. But then the one that I really dug is they got the G.I. Joe Striker, the Sky Striker, that F-15, you know, the pilot, or the the plane. Well, you can buy all these stickers and all these add-ons, but recently Cobra Commander just took over, and now you can get decals for their add-ons. Of you can turn it into a Cobra Sky Striker, and you can get a Cobra Commander and a pilot. That one starts at a semi-reasonable $229. So that's Hasbro Pulse, but staying on the GI. I'm going, Scungy. GI Joe.
No, it's cool because I literally picked Spangler's backpack and nice. The Rancor as well.
Nice. Okay, well, there you go. But staying on the G.I. Joe theme, I literally saw this at TJ Maxx about 2 hours ago when I was walking around with my 8-year-old Dean. I didn't know they had these G.I. Joe Legos. They're straight-up G.I. Joe Legos. Dean is outside right now building the little Fang copter, but it's forevercleverer.com. And when I Googled them, they've got a Rattler that has a Cobra Commander and a Destro minifig and two little... Cobra Infantry, but then they've got the Striker Mobile, which is kind of, it's got Snake Eyes minifig, but it's all G.I. Joe minifigs. It's not Legos. It's the knockoff Legos, but it's still pretty sweet. So for the G.I. Joe fan in your life, or for me, wink, wink, nudge, nudge, say no more, G.I. Joe logo, Legos, forevercleverer.com. All right, Scungy, one more, then we'll go to break. What you got?
So this is one that I'm if for the person in your life that enjoys their whiskey, I enjoy my whiskey. Mm. I do. But I've got this really, really cool thing I found. It's a Stormtrooper decanter.
Ooh.
So you buy it in. So a decanter is basically a glass bottle that you can put your liquor in and whatnot. So you make it all look nice and everything, and not just like a, hey, you got a bottle of Jack Daniels with the label there, or, a bottle of Buffalo Trace. You actually have it look nice. And you can trick people into thinking that it's more expensive than it is when it's in a bottle like that.
You're right. It's a fancy liquor.
So you can get this Stormtrooper decanter, and you also get a couple of glasses that have, like, when you pour the liquor in, it's like a floating... Stormtrooper helmet. So the decanter's a helmet, and it's like a floating helmet. Then you can add that in with a Death Star ice cube mold.
Ooh.
And you've just got the perfect, geek cocktail.
That is,
and
you're awesome.
Only like total of like for the decanter set, it's only like $30, and like the ice cube mold is like $10.
Dang, where at?
So I mean, it's a you can get that on Amazon, believe it or not.
Look
and
at
they
that.
They'll have shipping that, you'll be able to get it by Christmas. But I mean, it's just a cool little small thing that you can get for somebody.
There you go. When we come back, we'll hear from our friend Mark over at D4 Cafe. Scungy went and talked with Mac, and so he's got some stuff where you can buy local and help out our local people. And I've got something for the morbid Pokémon fan in your life, so you want to stick around for that. This is the Gifts for Geeks Holiday Spectacular on The Week in Geek on News Talk 99.5 WRNO. Hey y'all, D Squared here, and I'm joined by a special guest, the Go Forblin, to bring you a special announcement. That's right. Go Four Games, your friendly neighborhood game shop since 2010, is moving to 4953 West Napoleon Avenue in the Napoleon Plaza. Keep up to date with the move and Go Forblin's adventure on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at Go Four Games NOLA and GoForGamesNOLA.com. What's that? Oh, he says he can't wait for you to see his new pick of location at 4953 West Napoleon Avenue.
Prose Productions is a leading independent publisher on the cutting edge of new pulp and genre fiction today. At Prose Productions, you'll find fiction featuring fast-paced action and adventure, larger-than-life protagonists, over-the-top characters, and tight yet extravagant plots. Prose specializes in prose books, anthologies, audiobooks, and more. Go to prose-press.com to find our monthly release schedule and more info about our great titles. Prose Productions is your first-rate publisher of new pulp fiction today.
This is the Week in Geek, your source for geek and pop culture news that's trending now. Like them on Facebook and follow them on Twitter at Twig Radio. Do it now.
Whoa! Welcome back in to the Week in Geek, your source for geek and pop culture news that's trending now. And right now, it's gifts for geeks that are trending now. What to get the loved one that is a nerd or geek in your life. What you gotta get them to make them happy and not want to murder you in their sleep or something like that. But who would do that? It's Christmas. Put some love in your heart. Put a little love in your heart. All right, speaking of love, and I have no segue for this, the next gift I was talking about at Scungy is for the Pokémon fan in your life who is also very morbid. And, you know, maybe it's somebody who has, you know, way too much Pokémon stuff. If you want a Pikachu skull replica that is a 3D printed, cruelty-free, vegan taxidermy, it is a Pikachu skull replica. It looks just like the skull of your defeated Pikachu, and it's only $45 on Etsy. It's Pikachu skull replica, $45. It looks freaking hysterically awesome. And so, you know, look, sometimes you can't cram them into that ball, and you just got it. Sometimes you got to kill a Pokemon, and so why not have the leftovers of a dead Pikachu and just, you know, wear it proudly or put it proudly when you play Pokemon on the table and be like, you know, look at me, look at a skull, that's you, let's play some Pokemon. I think
I've seen the picture of it. It is terrifying.
It is terrifying and awesome at the same time. You know what's not terrifying, though? Putting your loved one's faces on cheese and then, you know, putting it in a grilled cheese. I found this, like, picture printer that would print your family's pictures on the cheese, and then you could make a grilled cheese out of it. But it turns out it was a gag gift. It was not real. I was very put out. But as I was, you know, consoling myself and further looking through the bowels of the internet, I came across some spice, 100% pure spice from Arrakis. And it was basically cinnamon in a bottle. So I'm like, you know what, Scungy? We could make our own spices if we bought a label maker. So they got label makers that don't use ink anymore. It's these cartridges where it's rolls of paper that it's adhesive on one side. And the ink is already in it. I don't know how it works. Don't ask me. It's probably like magic or something. But a label maker for $149, the label stuff is like $35. And then you could take whatever images, like from your phone, from the internet, whatever, slap it on there, and you could make your own spices. And I demand that somebody do this at a con and sell me some spice from Arrakis. You know, even if it's a cinnamon, you go to a dollar store, buy it for a dollar, Italian seasoning, you could do whatever, and then just make your own stuff right now. So if you do want to get somebody pure spice from Arrakis, though, it's $19 on Etsy. That's why I say, you know what? Why not make your own little pop-up market and just start creating your own spice from Arrakis and selling it, you know, bootleg at cons? I mean, is there anything wrong with that, Scungy? I think that's a solid
no
plan. Okay.
The spice must flow, and look, there's a market for it.
Well played. All right, what do you have next?
So there's this got this other game that just came in. This board game came out recently called Final Girl. Now I know you're gonna like this, Dave.
Okay.
Simply because it's a solo board game. You can't play with multiple people. You play it by yourself. That's it.
This is like solitaire, but it's got rules and better. Okay, I like it. I'm in. Yeah. I'm sold.
So the game, it's actually got a feature film system to it. You get the core box of it, and then you get these different chapters. One of them is, the game is called Final Girl.
Okay.
And in it, you are playing the final girl in a horror movie.
Oh, nice.
So it goes over the whole tropes of being, you know, in a horror movie. There's a serial killer, or
you must, like, run and trip. You have to trip like five or six times. Yeah.
Well, you have to actually go and save victims.
Oh.
So you're going and, like, trying to save, like, different victims, and if you do that, you get bonuses and more power. But if you let the killer kill people, he gets more powerful and stronger and whatnot. He has more abilities. But yeah, you do, like, it's some of these unbelievable tropes. Like, some of the things are set in, like, a creepy manor, or camp Happy Trails, you know, or a Carnival of Blood. And they have, like, different, like, legally distinct, but very similar to Freddy Krueger.
Right,
Dr.
I'm sure.
Fright. So, but it's such a fun game. Now, you can buy the game. You could buy one of the modulars, or you can buy all of them. But the cool thing is you can mix and match the killers and the locations, and each one comes with a different final girl. Well, two different final girls that have different abilities. So it's so much replayability that you can have when you buy these boxes. You can go to Van Ryder Games and pick up the bundle. I believe for everything, it's like for all different ones, it's like $100 to get all of them. But you can do them piecemeal if you want to.
Nice. All right. Well, we only got a few minutes left, so I want to knock these out. All right. So for the girl in your life, say you know your spouse doesn't want to cosplay or doesn't like to go to conventions and not be cosplaying out or whatever, and can't sew like most of us can't. Hot Topic has some cool Marvel's WandaVision. They've got the Wanda hooded girl's cape, from the end of the movie when she comes down with that red cape and she's got the red the top on. Well, the cape is at Hot Topic for like $43 right now, $44, and then the little top is only $20. So cheap cosplay for $60, and you can go to the Fan Expo coming up, and you can do Scarlet Witch WandaVision cosplay. So there you go. All right, now look, hey, you know what? D4 Game is open. D4 Cafe over there on Oak Street. Hey, Mark, what do you guys got over there, man?
Well, we got all kinds of RPGs. Aliens, great, fantastic horror games, Cyberpunk, which we all love from back in the 80s. And it's really hard to shop for nerds who already have everything. So we've got gift cards. We've got tons of tables. You can just come sit down and play. There's no rental fee for the tables, even though we can reserve one for you for $20. Otherwise, first come, first serve. Come get you something to eat, play some games. We'll clean up after you.
You said Aliens, the role-playing game.
What, RPG.
When did that happen?
I want to say it officially came out last year. It was trying to tie in, I think, if I remember correctly, with some kind of a
anniversary
production. Yeah. And but it's turned out to be a really great horror game. Colonial Marines book just came out for it, so now you can actually play from one of those nut jobs from Aliens. Exactly. And
was he stressed out? Tell me about Stress Dice.
Oh, Stress Dice. That's one of the fun mechanics of the system. Is you add more dice to it as the stress ramps up, and it puts stress on the players, and it's good to make them sweat.
Aliens. Hey, Merry Christmas, man. Thank you, buddy.
Thank you.
Aliens RPG. All right, Scungy, you talk with Mac at Go4 Games. Quick, we got about 60 seconds.
All right, so they've got going on now through the 31st. Any time that you spend $10 at Go4 Games, you're going to get $1 in Gopher Bucks that you can use between January 1st and January 28th on anything in the store. So basically, spend $10, get a dollar.
Nice.
And every week they're doing advent calendar sale type things. So like this week, Magic the Gathering Innistrad Command Deck, if you buy one of those, you will get 20% off of that and any other magic items that you get with it. And you can follow them on Facebook at go4games.com. They're going to put up their sales every week doing that.
And they got Pokemon cards too, right?
And they have the Pokemon cards where they're so hard to get right now.
Everybody needs Pokemon. So go get the Pokemon cards at go4games. Get the Pokemon skull on Etsy and taunt your enemies. All right, Merry Christmas, everybody. I don't know what's going on next week. Scungy, do you know what's going on? I don't know what's going on. But till next time, keep your nerd flag raised high.